the race, and we really should be actually heading off to the start line right now. Woke up with a bit of a sore eye from the windstorm last night, but well, what can you do? Just try to dress it as much as I can, and we'll just put my glasses on and pretend that it's not really swollen over.
Yeah, you too. Have fun out here.
Yeah, you too. They've been so like pure until the start of the race, and now I've had to have like a ibuprofen, and now they want to give me like antibiotics because of my eye. It's awesome. Kaka. We're about an hour in now. It's a little bit past seven. Had a bit of a chaotic start. Sam woke up. We had a pretty bad sandstorm yesterday. Sam woke up with a very swollen eye. Need to get some antibiotics into her. Her medical consultation before the race was going on. Well, the race was pretty much starting, so she had to run to the starting line. It was a bit chaotic. She was a bit emotional, so it wasn't really the best start to the race, but she's had a pretty solid start now. Ryan's a bit unwell, so he's heading ahead to the next town, so we'll see how we go. I think, you know, we'll iron out the creases and get going. Love bike curry. So hard. It's so hard. It's really hard, guys.
I know, baby.
It's really hard up the mountain.
We got snow for a minute. Then it got cloudy and we got some wind. And when the sun's out, it's hot. So it makes it difficult to prepare accordingly for clothing. But I think we're doing a pretty good job. Sam's feeling good. We're almost at the top. Or maybe another kilometer, two or three, and we celebrate.
It's snowing. It's coming down pretty heavily. When
we were. Is it landslide?
Yeah. Oh, do you know, it's feeling okay. It's my stomach. Like, the muscles in my stomach are really, really fatigued. And so every time I run, like, it just hurts it. So I'm doing this silly little, like, I feel like I could be like an Olympic
shuffler
power right now. Yeah. Like, yeah. It's ridiculous.
Tell you what, I tell her to watch this step, and I almost crashed the bike about four times.
Yeah. Tummy a bit sore, but I've had something for the tummy. And let's just get to Leh.
Happened, Sam?
Alright, I think I feel a bit better.
Yeah.
Oh. Did you say something, mate?
It's alright.
When I see you, I can just stand for about 7:15. So we've been going since, well, 4 in the morning if you start when we woke up. And we're coming into, we're about, what, 10k from Leh. And it's going to be a bit of a milestone. We've come off the, Sam's like second half, like coming down from Cut on Long Pass on the bike, which worked a treat. And then we've started walking with her through like kind of suburbia of Leh, because there's, you know, heaps of wild dogs and stuff. And then we've gotten to the supposed interview place, which is the Indian petrol station, and there's no one there. And then they've moved the camp to like 8k down the road, so we're just like cruising.
We were about 108k's in, I think, and when we reach 110k's, that is then officially the longest I've ever gone. Let the drama kick, the drama kick die. Let the drama kick, let the drama kick die. Let the drama kick, let the drama kick die. Let the drama kick, the drama kick die. Let the drama kick, the drama kick die. Our driver's flying, it's like here we are. Yeah, it's a little unnerving. It's kind of like with the break of a new day, you kind of like wipe out all the kind of tough parts of the previous day and you just start afresh. You know, there's going to be some more challenges for today, but currently feeling all right.
So hot out here. There's no shelter from the sun. The heat's just bouncing off the rocks. It's gonna be a long day, but only 50k to the top.
Yep.
It's all downhill from there.
Yeah.
Literally.
To the top, and it's pretty hot right now. Had a little tough moment before, but yeah, I'm fine now.
Quite hot outside, so Samantha's out there battling in the heat, but she's doing really well. We've only got a little bit to go now before Rumsey, which is the main camp before the second climb.
It looks like it's about to snow. It's blissful. Oh, it's blisteringly cold, which is crazy because just over an hour ago it was really hot, I was sweating.
Alright, so we just ran into Percy and his team. It's like a whiteout basically on top, so they're suggesting that we go back and stay here, go back, get warm, get some rest. And then when the storm clears, go after it again. So we need to make a decision on whether we want to go a little bit further. I mean, obviously it's a way down on top, we can't do this. It's for everyone in the car as well as him. It's not possible. How far we've gone. How far
we're going. It is better we go down, take some rest, and see that food in, come on, Betsy. The weather is clearing up, we can start to work. Us moving. Just past the peak of Tangalala. It's pretty cold.
And we're getting a bit worried with Samantha's temperature. It's dropped down to 92, and the doctors have said that if it doesn't go up soon, she may have to pull out of the race at this stage.
Just keep on. Let's go up to that.
97.6?
Yep.
Beautiful. Let's leave it.
Beautiful?
Yeah. Awesome. That's awesome. 97.6 is the exact right temperature.
Keep your heart close to the ground.